Hello friends, myself Amar. In this video I will discuss another widget of Flutter which is called as scaffold widget. Okay, now before discussing scaffold widget, let me tell you what is fat arrow. If you can see here in the main function, only one statement is written, that is run app. Okay, now functional expression in Dart says that if a function contains only one statement, then that can be reduced by using fat arrow. How? Simply remove these curly braces, and in the function here we can use fat arrow. Okay, that's it. I will simply remove these lines from here to here. Okay, this is how we can use functional expression by using fat arrow in Dart. Okay, now what is scaffold widget? Scaffold widget is used to display app bar in our app. Okay, how to use a scaffold widget? Now I will start from the last video where I have left. Now here what I will do, in this home section here I will use the widget which is called as scaffold widget. Okay, this scaffold widget will have an attribute which is called as app bar. Here I will use app bar. Now here I am using title attribute, and in the title I am writing text, and here I am giving the title as app bar. Okay, and this scaffold widget has another attribute which is called as body, right? In the body what I will do, I will simply cut this and paste it here. Okay, now remove this semicolon from here and it will come here. Okay, that's it. Now I have run this. Now if you can see, this is the app bar which is coming, right? And the title where I have given app bar, this app bar is displaying here. Now suppose I want to change its color. How to change its color? Here I will use another property which is called as style. Okay, in the style I will write text style. Now text style will have another attribute which is called as color. I will set the colors as like colors dot, let me give it to suppose purple accent. Okay, let me save this. Once you save this, then you will see, now see the color is changed. Okay, that is app bar. Now let me remove this color because it is not looking good. Okay, I have just shown you how to change its color. Let me remove this. Okay, now suppose here in the app bar I want to put an icon. Okay, how to put the icon? To put the icon, it has an attribute. This app bar has an attribute which is called as, let me show you. It has an attribute which is called as leading. Okay, in the leading I will use a icon, and what icon I want to give, for that here we need to write icons dot. Now here you will see a list of icons. Okay, here I am choosing menu. That's it. Save this. Once you save this, then you will see icon is coming here. Okay, now suppose in this app bar in the right hand side I want to place two more images or two more icons. How to do that? And I also want that on clicking those icons something will happen. To do that, this app bar has another attribute which is called as actions. Okay, in the actions, if you can see, it is taking an array of widget. This means here we can place multiple widgets, right? Now in this array I am using icon button. Okay, icon button. Now this icon button has an attribute which is called as icon, and as an icon I am placing icons dot. Suppose here I am taking shopping cart, and on clicking those icons what will happen, that we can specify by using on pressed. Okay, in the on pressed here I am just putting curly braces. inside this curly braces you need to write the code. What will happen whenever I will click on that particular icon? Okay, now what I will do, I will put a comma here and I will copy this line, paste. Let me change the icon here to something which is monetization on. Okay, that's it. Let me save this. Once you save this, now see, these icons are coming here. Okay, now when you will click this, nothing is happening because I have not written any code for that, right? Now suppose what I want is that I want to disable the button. To disable the button, what I will do is that, suppose I want to disable this shopping cart, I will remove this curly braces here and inside this parenthesis I will simply write null. Now save this. Once you save it, now you can see the changes. Now see, this icon has been disabled. Now you, the user will not be able to click. Okay, this is how we can use app bar. We can place the title to the app bar, we can place icon to the app bar, and we can place icon buttons to the app bar. Okay, if you like my video, please subscribe my channel. Thank you so much.